I'm going to show you how to make some wavy water text with PowerDirector. Let's catch the Mickey frickin' wave. First, we need to create our text. So we're going to go up to the title room. We're going to go to the default text, hold down our left mouse button, and drag this down to track one. Then we'll double left click on the text. We're going to go ahead and select our font. And we're going to use lemon. Change our font size. We're going to make it nice and big. Then we'll type in the text that we want to show. And now we're going to go to align objects. And we're going to choose horizontal center. And we'll go back to align objects. And we're going to choose vertical center. Now, if the words aren't exactly where you want them to be, you can place your cursor over this line until you see it crosshairs. Hold down your left mouse button and you can move it, drag it up, down, whatever you need to do. Once you're done, you can go ahead and click on OK. And then we'll go ahead and we'll click on the snapshot button. We'll choose the location where we want the snapshot to go. And we'll give it a name. And we'll click on save. Now we can go ahead and remove the title from the timeline by left clicking on it and pressing the delete key on our keyboard. And now we want to go ahead and create the water. So we're going to go back up here to the media room. And we're going to go to color boards. So we're going to go to the orange color board. We're going to hold on our left mouse button over it, and we're going to drag this down to track three. And then we'll place our cursor over it in the preview window, hold on our left mouse, and we're going to drag this up. And that's good there. Then we're going to go to the blue color board, hold on our left mouse button over it, and drag it down to track two. We'll place our cursor over it in the preview window, hold on our left mouse button, and drag this one down. And then we'll go to this teal color board, hold on our left mouse button, and drag it down to track one. Now we're going to add the ripple effect. First thing that we need to do is add an effect track because we want the effect to impact all of the color boards above the effect. So we're going to right click over here on the tracks. We're going to select add tracks. We're going to change video tracks to zero. We'll change audio tracks to zero. And for effect, we're going to change it to one. And we're going to put it above track four. And click on OK. Now we're going to go to the effects room. And in the search box, we're going to type ripple. And we're going to place our cursor over the effect, hold on our left mouse button, and we're going to drag this down to the effects track that we just created. Place our cursor at the end until we see these two arrows pointing in opposite directions. Hold on our left mouse button and trim this in so that it's the same duration as the color boards. Now we need to make some changes to the effect. So we're going to click on keyframe. We're going to make sure that our playhead is at the beginning. And for wavelets, we're going to change that to one. Speed, we're going to go ahead and change that to 9. In progress, we're going to change that to 155. Then we want to move our playhead to the end. And we'll change wavelets once again to 1. Our speed, we want to keep it the same, so we're going to go ahead and change that to 9. In our progress, we're going to move that up to 200. Now we can go ahead and close this out. Next, we'll need to go ahead and add our text. So we're going to go back to the media room. And we're going to make sure that we're under media content. And we're going to take the snapshot that we created, hold on our left mouse button, and drag this to track 4. Then we're going to go to Tools. And we'll go to Blending Mode. And for the blending mode, we're going to go ahead and select Darken. And we'll click on OK. Now we can see the colors through the text. So we're going to go ahead and double left click on the orange text. We want to make sure that our playhead is all the way at the beginning. And we're going to drag our color right above the water. And then we're going to add a position keyframe here. And we're going to move our playhead all the way to the end. And we're going to go ahead and place our cursor over the color board until we see the crosshairs. We're going to hold on our left mouse and we're going to drag this right below the text that says water. And what this does is it makes the orange go down the screen. And so now we're going to go ahead and click on OK. And now we'll double left click on the blue color board. Want to make sure that our playhead is all the way at the beginning. We want to drag our blue color board right below the word water. We'll add a position keyframe here. We'll move our playhead all the way to the end. And then we'll go ahead and drag the color board right above the word water. And we'll click on OK. And now we can play this back and see what it looks like. I'm feeling a little seasick up in here. If you want to place your text behind a moving object, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.